On your way now.
I'm not finished with him yet.
Oh, leave him alone, mate. Not worth it, is he?
All right. If you say so. It goes against
me. How about a beer, eh?
Waitress, one whiskey, one beer. Where'd you learn that?
I spent 15 years with a knife thrower. He used to pin his wife down every night, on the stage, of course. But he happened to slip once.
Nice little toy, Doctor.
Comes in handy from time to time.
Where'd you meet this knife thrower? Tell us. In a circus?
Not exactly. We used to share a room, as a matter of fact. Bars in front of the window. Lovely view, though. Over the moors.
You were in Dartmoor.
Oh, I didn't say that, did I? Good health.
What are you up to now?
That's my business, chum.
I don't approve of this fellow.
How? Well, come to think of it, I don't think much of you either. I wouldn't have thrown one of these pretty little things if it had been to save your lovely pies. Where'd you dig them up, anyway? Ladies' addresses? Well, thanks for the beer.
Just a minute. What's your name?
What's your game, mister?
All right, boys.
What's the idea?
Just a minute. That's all. Man's all right. Release papers from Dartmoor. What were you sentenced for?
It's none of your business.
Uh-huh. Most interesting. Herewith, Lawrence Alexander Kopernik, originally sentenced for burglary, is to report weekly at police headquarters to his parole officer.
All right, now you know.
Police!
All right. Well, let's have a talk.
Sit down.
If you're interested, we might have a job for you.
How much?
Oh. It pays. Here you have a map of the underground sewers. Now, that's where we're planning to operate. Look. Now, here.
We are here, and over here is the Mosley Auction House. The policeman will take this route. I have the entire circuit under heavy guard. Holmes thought it advisable. He believes the necklace will be snatched before it gets to Mosley's. It seems rather far-fetched to imagine anyone trying to steal a package from a sealed police van right in broad daylight. In any event, I will be in the van with two of my men. Yes, we'll leave in exactly 15 minutes.
Right you are, Inspector.
Ah, Holmes.
Thank you.
move on. All right. Go ahead now.
And here is a vase, 1200 BC, exceptionally well preserved, bidding to start at £1,000. Do I hear 1100? 1100.
1200.
Do I hear 1300?
1300.
Will anyone offer 1400? Do I hear 1400? Going at 1300? 1300. Going, going, gone.
Sold to the gentleman in the center.
Head of a tomb statue, the only known one of its kind. What am I bid? Head of King Amenhotep II, do I hear any bids? Ladies and gentlemen, I regret to inform you that the Cleopatra necklace, which was to have gone on sale today, has been withdrawn from the auction as it is not available
to us. It's been withdrawn? What's the meaning of this? I don't understand why it is that the most valuable things always vanish.
1300. Do I hear 14? Does anyone bid 1400? Going at 1300. At 1300.
Not bidding, Professor.
Going, going,
have all the objects I'm interested in.
Are you quite sure?
To the lady in the rear.
Unless you should happen to be aware of something which might tempt me.
Far be it from me to give any suggestions to an expert such as yourself. I understand you believe in buying as little as possible.
That's what is most satisfying. Somehow many of the best objects seem to find their way into my private collection.
What am I offering?
Not always, Professor.
Excuse me, is there a Mr. Holmes here?
Yes?
Would you please step into the office?
Thank you.
What am I bid for this unique example of early Egyptian pottery? Ladies and gentlemen, do I hear any bids?
£900.
£900. Do I hear 1,000?
1,000.
Do I hear 1,100?